had left, and the winter came, and the sky fell to only bring the rain. I sat in darkness, all brokenhearted. I couldn't find a day, I didn't feel alone. I never meant to cry, started losing hope. But somehow, baby, you broke through and saved me. You're an angel, tell me.
Mercy doesn't show up on this day. We pray that you continue to watch over us, guide us, direct us, and bless us. And we pray that as family, friends, that we will help Brent and Lauren as they join in holy matrimony tomorrow to provide advice, counseling, coaching, and experience, wisdom, as they start their marriage together. We pray that the food we receive tonight will be used for the nourishment of our body and the upbuilding of your kingdom. Of course, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I am loving you. Days from the darkest nights, you're the riverbank where I was baptized, cleansed from the demons that were killing my freedom. Let me lay it down, give me to ya, get you singing, babe, hallelujah. We'll be touching heaven. You're an angel, tell me you're never leaving, 'cause you're the first. I know I can't believe in you. Saving grace, you're my kind of church, you're holy.
I was a boat stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea. Just forgot on the shelf, no wind in the sails, going nowhere with no one but me. I was one in 100 billion, a burnout star in a galaxy. Just lost in the sky, wondering why everyone else shines out for me. But I came to life when I first kissed you. The best me has his arms around you. Can make me better than I was before. Thank God I'm yours. I was a worn out set of shoes, wandering the city streets. Another face in the crowd, head looking down, lost in the sound of a lonely melody. And empty pockets and a roulette, always landing on a lost bet. Just live for the spin, hope for the win, go all in just to lose again. But I came to life when I first kissed you. The best me has his arms around you. Make me better than I was before. Thank God I'm yours. The worst me is just a long gone memory. You put a new heartbeat inside of me. You make than I was before. Thank God I'm yours. Oh. I was a boat stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea.
We are gathered here in the sight of God in the presence of these witnesses, joined together, Lauren and Brent, in holy matrimony. This is an honorable state, instituted of God and signifying to us the mystical union that exists between Christ and his church. Christ adorned and beautified this with his presence in Cana of Galilee, where the first recorded wedding took place. Therefore, it's not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the presence of God. Who gives this woman to be given to this man?
Her mother and I do.
Very good. You may be seated. First and foremost, I'd like to welcome everyone. You've gotten your dose of what our East Tennessee weather is truly like. Last night, of course, you were t-shirts and shorts, 70 degrees. This morning, it's 14, and it's like, this is the way we welcome you. In the book of Genesis, it says it's not good for man to be alone. God gave Adam a task of naming animals, and that's what Adam did. One thing God noticed, though, is every animal had a partner, and Adam did not. So he caused Adam to fall into a deep sleep. And as he slept, he removed one of Adam's ribs and created this in his image. The reason why he removed one of Adam's ribs is for the sign, a partner, and their equal partner in their life's journey together. In 1 Corinthians, it says, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast. Love is not proud, nor is love rude. Love is not self-seeking, nor is love easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in truth, as love bears all things, believes all things. Love never fails. I'd like you to look into each other's eyes, hold each other's hands tightly there. There you go. Maybe warm your hands up a little bit there. I want you to take this moment, because today starts a new journey for the both of you. So I want you to take a moment, look into each other's eyes. Family and friends are present here together today.
Brent, you take Lauren to your wedded wife to live together in the state of holy matrimony. Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live? If so, please answer, I do.
I do.
Very good. Lauren, you take Brent to your lawfully wedded wife in the state of holy matrimony. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live? Please answer, I do.
I do.
We're off to a good start. So now, Brent, I want you to look lovingly into Lauren's eyes. Please, here you go. I'm going to hand you a repeat after me. Okay? I, Brent. Take you, Lauren.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
This is my pledge to you and to God. Very good. And now, Lauren, I want you to look into Brent's eyes lovingly, please. I want you to repeat after me. I, Lauren.
Take you, Brent.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or for poor. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. This is my pledge to you and to God. Very good. And now the rings, please.
Two.
Yes.
Before you do that, the wedding. He's excited. I like that. He wants to put a ring on it really bad. Before we do this, a couple things though with the wedding. The wedding ring. The marriage itself is more the unity of both people. The wedding ring is a symbol of that unity. But as you exchange your ring today, and as you repeat the words, have them mean something to each other. Understand the commitment that you're taking with you today, that anywhere you go, you will always look at that ring and say, I am married to you, so I have the best friend. And you carry that with you from now until the rest of your day. So, Brent, place that ring on Lauren's left hand. Look at her eyes and repeat after me. I, Brent.
I, Brent.
There you go. I, Brent. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
Very good. Excellent. Ask you to do the same. Place that ring on the left hand ring finger there for me. Hold his hand, support the hand. There you go. Actually, there you go. Look into his eyes and repeat after me. I'm Lauren.
Hi, Lauren.
I give you this ring.
Give me this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
Symbol of my love.
And commitment to you.
Commitment to you.
And with all that I am.
And all that I am.
And all that I have. With this ring, I be wed.
Perfect.
And now at this time, I'd like everyone to please bow their heads as I'd like to say a blessing over you. God, I thank you for the blessing of this day. Lauren and Brent, you're not unified. I ask you, Brent, for happiness and contentment as they establish a new home together. Bless their families, their friends, and relationships that have sustained them and strengthened them throughout their lives, and help them to continue. Remember the love that has brought them here together today. May they visualize their marriage as more than just the bonding of two lives, but as two on a mission for you, as a lighthouse of refuge and a welcome place for encouragement. May they cherish this day, their wedding day, as a sacred memorial and their union as a treasure to protect all the time. Help them to continue to believe that all things are possible through you, the one who began the good work. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Lauren and Brent, you have consented together. You've given your vows to each other. You've given rings to each other. The symbols are by the power and destiny of the state of Tennessee. It is truly my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. So, Brent, you can kiss your bride.
Created with Lauren and Brent, that their bonds will grow stronger,
as their family grows and their love grows and the family around them will continue to support them, guide them, direct them, give them advice. And we just pray that the food we eat today will be for the nourishment of our body, for the upbuilding of your kingdom. First, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Bound up for worse or for better, and I will be all you need. Beside you I'll stand, through the good and the bad. We'll give all that we have, and we'll build this love from the ground. Go by in the blink of an eye, but I wouldn't want to spend it without you by my side. The clouds are gonna roll, the earth's gonna shake, but I'll be a shelter through the wind and the rain. And we'll build this love from the ground up, now till forever. It's all in me, all of you. Just take my hand, and I'll be the man your dad hoped that I'd be. And we'll build this love from the ground up.
But also, as the firstborn, she was this true trooper. We're like, can you do some activities? And she was the first one to try it. I remember, Lauren, what, Daisy Scouts? What, soccer, tennis, gymnastics, swimming, a lot of you know that one, dance, cheerleading. And the one thing Karen and I realized, she had a kind heart.
Ever I've ever been around. I know I've told you this, Brent, many times, but you are one lucky man. It's honest, just the way that you look at her, the way you glance at her, everything. I just know it's been right, it has been.
In that way, I really feel like Lauren and I's story has come full circle. Best friends from high school, dreaming of the love of your life, and now I can't help but think that you found that way, Brent.
Yeah,
it says 10 hours.